like sometimes I feel like as an artist, like the songs that I write about, I mean, everything I write is really quite political and I'm opinionated. Did you get that? Kind of, sort of, maybe. But I am. And I think I always have this freak out, like, that I'm going to go, like, via the LA airport one day and they're just going to grab me and, like, lock me up and say, why are you writing songs about this and you can't be anti-Trump and blah, blah, blah. I really am. Like, you just kind of think those things up. Like, people that go missing and stuff. I want to tell you this also, I'm doing something really, I feel is really incredible for me and for my child and her future, is as of October last year, I got asked to go to the Amazon and come together with the indigenous peoples. There were 30 tribes of the Amazon that came together with Chief Rani. And and there were 200 indigenous peoples from around the world representing their cultures. And one of the things, the reason why we came together was we were asked by Chief Rani to write the rights of Mother Nature for the United Nations and the world states. And we just did that recently. And one of the things about being an artist is, you know, I've read the outline of this festival and it talks about taking risks and being brave. And I certainly feel that on this tour we've kind of we've pieced together all these tracks and these songs and stuff and our dances and stuff to really come together in solidarity, especially with the Indigenous women here. And one of the things that we do as women is we are the, in our culture we have a saying where we are the holders of the waters of life. And this next song is called Why Water. And Why Water is all about the health and well-being of water. And it's really, really, really important to us as a people. In New Zealand, people don't realize this, you know. How many of you think that New Zealand's a beautiful, green country that you want to go on a holiday to? Yeah. 100% pure everything. Yeah. Sounds great, doesn't it? So, in every country, as you probably, if you're an educated person, you get to travel or you just look it up on Google, you generally find that there's always something else going on in the background. And one of the things that happened to our country in the last 15 years, we had the national government, under the government, they did a free trade agreement with China. And unfortunately, what that created was, in that free trade agreement, we had a massive increase of agriculture. So everybody knows about New Zealand, milk and beef and all that kind of stuff. Well, what the problem with that is, we now feed our cows palm oil extract from Indonesia, which unfortunately when it goes into the cows, it comes out the other end, it goes into our waterways and it creates an algae that's poisoned. 90% of New Zealand's waterways are unswimmable. You cannot drink in them. Our children can no longer play in them. This has just happened in 15 years. So this is something that's really important to us, to share these things so we raise awareness about how we look after ourselves. First, mostly, not mostly, and how we look after the planet in that process through looking after ourselves and looking after the waters within our bodies, the waters within our spirits, and the waters within the land, and how we all, that is a symbiotic thing. We are human beings, we are part of nature, we are human, we use our human nature. And yeah, I'm a really big believer in just trying to share that story anyway. So this is Why Water. Thank you.
Māori flag. Now what this flag represents is the blood of the people, which is our connection to our land. We fly this flag on this land in solidarity with the First Nations.